It's not often that you come across a perfectly designed magic card, but today, that's exactly what we're going to discuss. Greetings, owners of fine luxury cardboard rectangles. I have been feeling a little bit down about Magic the Gathering lately. It may be noticeable to some of you, especially those of you who may have been in the stream earlier today. And so I thought to myself, what do I want to talk about? I'm like, let's talk about something that actually gets me excited, like full on excited about Magic the Gathering. And there's actually a card from Commander 2019 that feels 100% King Cube worthy. And if you don't know what King Cube worthy means, don't worry. Sometime soon, I will introduce you to my King Cube and you will love it as I love it. Anyhow, cards come along every once in a while that make you go, wow, they really knocked it out of the park. All the little parts come together to make something that not only looks right, but feels right as well. It all ties together and there's nothing about it that makes you go, wait, this doesn't make sense, or this could have been done in a better fashion. Now, the card we are going to discuss today is Grismold. So let's get him up here on the screen. So Grismold, the Dread Sower, which is a pretty cool name, honestly. The whole thing, like I said, it all ties together. I like the idea, first of all, of Grismold makes you think of like grizzly, gristly. The mold has to do with plant life, and that will come into play. The Dread Sower, and sowing can be thought of in terms of things like you've got your crops, you've got plants, things of that nature. And dread, obviously, can be thought of dreadful things, being filled with fear. So I feel like the name is actually very green and black. In Grismold, the grizz part feels black, the mold part feels green. Dread Sower, Dread Sower could be entirely black, but it can also feel black green, with dread representing black and sower part representing green, all coming together to harvest a crop of dread. And that's just the name, my friends. So Grismold is a legendary troll shaman. That's a fun concept. Legendary trolls are cool. I like that. That's definitely got a heavy fantasy flavor to it. Now, he is a 3/3 trampler. I like the fact that he's 3/3 for 3 mana. That's enjoyable to me. I like seeing that sort of across the board. Multiple instances of the same number across a card is pleasing for some reason that I can't really put my finger on exactly. Now, he's a 3/3 trampler. At the beginning of your end step, each player creates a 1/1 green plant creature token. Now, this is a little bit different than some of the other token creators that we see in green. You'll see things like you'll have your Verdant Force or that newer one. What is that one called again? It's 2/2 for 5 from Rivals of Ixalan. And the name is eluding me right now, in all honesty. I'm sure some of you are screaming it at the stream right now. But anyhow, I'll toss up an image real quick of Verdant Forest and the Ixalan Dryad that I'm thinking of. And they both make tokens, specifically green tokens, during each of your upkeep. So your upkeep, your opponent's upkeep, your upkeep, your opponent's upkeep. So this one's different. This one is giving everybody a 1/1 green plant creature token. And the other ability is when a creature token dies, put a +1/+1 counter on Grismold the Dread Sower. So you can see which side of the card is green, and you can see which side of the card is black. The green side is the creation of the plant tokens. That's green, nature, and growth. The black side of it is whenever a creature token goes, you get a +1/+1 counter on him, and that is strength through decay and loss, which is a very, very much black-feeling style ability. So you have both of these represented color-wise, put together, and with a very interesting spin put on it for Commander. Because when you view the design of a card, it's important to also factor in the audience that card was designed for. So this was designed for Commander. And cards like this that give all players something tend to be more attractive overall, because cards like that can make you friends on top of just giving you an advantage. I don't know how many of you were playing way back in the day, but Howling Mind is an artifact that people would put out, and Howling Mind lets everybody draw an extra card each turn. So I played big multiplayer games where everybody would cheer whenever somebody put out a Howling Mind or a Mana Flare, for example. Anything that benefits everyone makes people happy. And making people happy can make them less likely to attack you as well, right? They may be less likely to launch an attack on you if they want to gain these creature tokens from your creation here, and that may let you stay in the game longer, which is advantageous. Also, note that instead of being an upkeep trigger, he's an end step trigger, which in Commander can make a huge difference. It means you are far more likely to get at least one trigger off of this. Because when you're playing Commander, if you're playing a 4 or 5 player game, multiple people are going to have turns before it returns to you, and as a result, your creatures can get wiped out before you have a chance to benefit from their ability. So right away, he gives out 1/1s to everybody. You and all of your opponents all get a 1/1, and if anything happens to them, your Grismold is going to grow as a result of it. And the concept of this troll that just feeds off of like life for it, while he nurtures life while also feeding off of that life. And the artwork for the card is also an absolute home run. I adore it. I like the contrast of how he has a kind of a light, almost inviting feel to him when you just give him a very quick glance. You see the bright green energy flowing up out of his hand where he is causing life to bloom. You see him covered in all these vines and colorful flowers. And so you go, oh, look, it's kind of an inviting fairy tale sort of dude. And then you look closer and you go, oh, wait, no. You look at his face and you see the vicious look on his face and the big tusks that are sticking up. And you look up on his shoulder and you notice there's actually a tiny skull up there with vines breaking loose and flowing free from them. And he's covered in what are most likely poisonous mushrooms. You can see those on his belly and all along his arms. The artwork also gives a sense of foreboding when you take it in as a whole, because behind him, it's very, very dark. He is, if you notice the contrast between him and the area behind him, not only is it dark, but it almost seems bereft of life. Now, yes, the trees behind him do technically count as life, but look at them. They are all kind of, to a degree, looking somewhat stunted and gnarly. There is not a single shred of life to be seen on them, however. You can guess the trees are probably alive, but there are no leaves. This looks like a dark forest that you would be wandering through, most likely in an autumn style. So this is autumn at night. So it's going to be cold and dark. And looming up out of the darkness comes this troll that at first glance is green and glowing with this bright life energy. And you may think, oh, a friend. And then you see his vicious face and the massive club that he is swinging and the remnants of death that he is wearing on his body as ornamentation, and it's going to give you pause. And the whole thing, the whole feeling of this kind of half-dead forest, or a forest in a state of receding life, contrasted against the life that is flourishing on the troll, gives this a very green-black feel. Overall, the entire concept of the card is transmitted fantastically, and you can see where the plant creatures are coming from. They're growing out of his hands. They're growing off of his body. He literally feeds life off of death. It is it's like the circle of life embodied in one being. And the fact that he just grows stronger and stronger. And there's so many details that I legitimately did not notice until right now. That head that is up on his shoulder, there's actually an arm attached to that. There's at least like half a body on him. the more I look at this, the more I realize you can actually see one arm hanging down along his arm, and the other hand is peeking out behind his neck. He is essentially allowing a body to mulch and act as fertilizer on his back. Imagine that. You're traveling through this dark, dense, autumnal forest at night, and you see glowing light up ahead, and you're like, oh, maybe this will be someone who will help me find my way out of this forest. And instead, you see this troll just picking up bodies off the forest floor and slinging them onto his back, where you can see other bodies have started to rot to the point where giant vines are busting out through the top of the skull, out through the mouth, the body hanging there all limp off of him. You just know that could be you. You could be next. That might be, depending on the size of Grismold overall, because we don't have a full sense of proportion, humans are tend to be 0-1 or 1-1 in Magic the Gathering, and he's 3-3. So that could be a full man-sized body on him. These trees could actually be larger than originally they originally appear. And again, I really love the darkness of the forest behind him, with some spiky looking like giant thorns almost coming off down in the bottom right-hand corner. But either way, the entire flavor of this, it's tied together perfectly. The art makes perfect sense for his abilities. The abilities make perfect sense for his colors. The abilities make perfect sense for Commander. This is literally how you design a perfect Magic card. And I am very, very impressed by it. I really like this card. So, my friends, at this point, it's time for you to let me know what you guys think about this card. Does this card encompass perfect design to you? What cards do encompass perfect design for you? Now, I want to take a moment and shout out my new channel members and patrons. I really appreciate you guys supporting my work. So, Alan McCandless, Alan McNoCandles, as he's known, Brett Flintoff, Mystery Meat 73, and Andrew Fellers, thank you all for joining my channel membership. I very much appreciate it. And James P. the Iron Man, thank you for joining my Patreon. I appreciate all of you very much, including all my channel members and all my patrons. So thanks for being here, my friends. And remember, together, we are the Sixth Color of Magic.